And this is already the third day here at the ADEX 2018 International Defense Exhibition in Baku. And for this final video daily report, we will put the spotlight on foreign companies' latest innovations.
This system, this Bogomol system, self-propelled anti-tank, so it's used to kill tanks. This system is very hard to detect on the battlefield. First of all, due to its small size, very compact size. Second, the system is covered with paint that makes it even harder to detect. Advantage number three, we use a hybrid power supply system here. In combat mode, the system is powered electrically. Strictly electrically, which makes it almost invisible in infrared band. Put together, all these advantages makes the system almost invisible for the enemy. Also, the system is equipped with an optronic subsystem. The optronic subsystem can detect targets at the range of at least 10 kilometers. Bogomol is also a smart system. It's able to detect, lock on and track targets, but also it's able to distinguish between targets, to differentiate between them. So as soon as it sees anything, it can able to tell what's in front of it. Like it may be like a tank, it may be a BTR, a BMP, any sort of vehicle. It's able to differentiate and make its own decisions. Here you see that the system is equipped with Storm BM anti-tank missiles, but like according to the customer's requirements, we are ready to equip it with any types of anti-tank missiles or even air defense like anti-aircraft missiles. Now, in regard to how the system is controlled, it basically has two modes. Mode number one, it can be controlled remotely by an operator, and operator can be located within 5 kilometer distance from the system itself. The second mode, this system is equipped first of all with artificial intelligence and secondly with inertial navigation system. So, like, these two factors make it possible to pre-program the system to move into a combat mission area and operate there independently without any participation with any operator or any human whatsoever. It's also important to know that we supply this system as a part of a like larger complex. The combat vehicle itself, the UAV, the unmanned aerial vehicle, and also the workstation of the operator. So we'll supply all this equipment to the customer like as a complex. Also, if you have a number of Bogomol combat vehicles out there in the field, they can communicate with one another automatically and they can coordinate and adjust their actions in regard to what the other systems are doing at the moment. At this exhibition, we present Polonez missile system that is produced by enterprises of State Military Industrial Committee of the Republic of Belarus. In peacetime, this system is a very powerful means of strategic deterrence that is able to influence the contents of military and political decisions. During wartime, the system is applied to perform deep strikes at critically important military sites and objects within the tactical depths of enemy defense. The main advantages of the system in comparison with similar ones, first of all, is a very, very significant range of operation up to 300 kilometers and high precision of fire, and also the fact that guided missiles are used in the system. The combat control vehicle is designed to control and coordinate actions of combat vehicles and transloaders during combat operation, and also to coordinate actions of a military unit while performing missile launches.
When you walk around here, you see a lot of hardware. You see a lot of tanks, vehicles, helicopters, fighter jets. There's a lot of very expensive material, and it's good to have, you need it. But what you also need is to know where to go. If you have a tank, the tank needs to know where to go. If you have a fighter jet, the fighter jet needs to know where to go. And this is where we come in. We are in a time where there is a lot of information. A lot of that information has a geographical component. It's location specific, satellite images, radar feeds, GPS location, video feeds. So all of that information, all these sensors that are creating, you know, generating information, you know, we need to know how to make use of them. Challenge that we have is there is too much information. And then, you know, what we need to do is to learn how to make better use, and that's what we do. The technology that we have developed the past 20 years, focusing on military, focusing on defense, is to create software that can absorb all the geospatial data and enable the user to perform analysis on that data to make real-time live decisions. So that the software is designed for real-time mission-critical, let's say, applications, command and control systems. Real live operations in the field, you need geospatial data. The tools that we provide are there to build custom solutions for customers. So that's why we are here in Azerbaijan. Azerbaijan is it's a country where there is the most, let's say, activity when it comes to defense. But the local industry is not as developed as they should be. Our customers are Leonardo Company, Airbus, Thales, Saab, they all use Sociat technology. But in Azerbaijan, we want to also offer the opportunity for local companies to build capabilities. Our customers are the middleman that uses our software to build customized applications for the Navy, for the Coast Guard, for the police, for the intelligence services. So we are providing a technology that they don't believe exists. So in the first place, it's about educating. You know, we need to educate the people here about what the possibilities are. In the second stage, we want to meet companies and partner with companies. In this case, we are partnering also with RISC, a local Azerbaijan company, that can act as a system integrator and that can act as a sort of industry, local industry, to service this country.
At ADEX 2018 exhibition, the Israeli company Elbit Systems is presenting for the first time its new Atmos M46 130mm truck-mounted howitzer variant to the Azerbaijani armed forces. The version showcased in Baku mounts for the first time the Russian M46 130mm towed field gun. This prototype is an interesting mix for the Azerbaijani armed forces, which still operates 36 M46 guns acquired from Bulgaria. According to CIPRI, Azerbaijan already operates at least 5 Atmos 2000 systems. Baku may now progress in modernizing its artillery capabilities by ordering a new batch of systems based on this M46 variant. But ADEX outdoor area is once again especially highlighting a handful of rarely seen defense projects. Beside the Atmos M46 we just talked about, the Russian Vehicle Manufacturer Military Industrial Company, or VPK, is presenting not less than 6 different variants of its famous Tiger 4x4 light armored vehicle. Among them is a new 2S12 mortar carrier variant showcased for the first time outside of Russia. The whole system is now installed in a single vehicle, with the mortar system replacing the troops compartment at the rear of the Tiger M vehicle. The 2S12 Sani mortar system can fire up to 10 rounds per minute within a maximum firing range of 7 km. It can fire high explosive, smoke, illuminating or incendiary rounds. According to VPK, this new mortar carrier vehicle is specially designed to destroy or suppress manpower or weapons located in open field or protected positions.
Dear ladies and gentlemen, it's our great honor to welcome you at the 3rd Azerbaijan International Exhibition ADEX 2018. Over 220 companies from 29 countries all around the world and over 35 international military delegations had visited ADEX 2018. We have a lot of bilateral meetings between exhibitors and military leadership of Azerbaijan and also military delegations of foreign countries. We'll be very glad to see you at ADEX 2020, which will be held on September of 2020. See you. Thank you very much.